absolutely what everyone is saying it is. It looks good, it's glowy. Greetings and salutations. Hey girl, hey, what is up? Today we are obviously wear testing, as you can see by the title, but I'm very excited to be testing out the new viral Winky Luxe Peeper Perfect Concealer. And I say new sparingly because it's been out for a while. I actually have had the concept of doing a full face of Winky Luxe on my like possible video list for, I want to say, a year. But then I was wondering if anyone was actually interested at all. So if you do want to see some sort of more in-depth review, full face of Winky Luxe, let me know by giving this video a thumbs up. I originally found this concealer, as I'm sure many of you did as well, on TikTok. If you haven't followed me on my account, there's the code for you guys. I've been doing a lot of Amazon favorites lately, so you should definitely check it out. Back to the concealer. I originally saw this when Michaela did a video on it, which, you know, made it super, super viral. But originally, she found this from Abby, the badass mom. She stitched it with her, and she did an amazing demo video. So credits to both of them for me discovering this product. I originally was like, ooh, I wanna try it. Hydrating finish, great coverage, affordable. Says my name all over it, right? But of course, it was gonna be sold out. It actually had a few shades left on their website, but I couldn't figure out the shades. I didn't know what to do. I really didn't, because I couldn't get all the shades I wanted to. They only had like one. And I was like, is that too light? Is that too dark? And I'm sure a lot of you guys who are interested in it possibly are going through the same thing. So here my video is to help. I have three different shades. I have light, light beige, and light medium. I actually found this at Target, so I felt like this was meant to be. I was just walking through grabbing some body wash or something like that. And I was like, oh! And I ran over. Of course, the display was destroyed and people threw things everywhere. But I was able to get one of each shade. There's definitely a lot of lights left, but this line has 9 shades, and those swatch shades to me look really confusing to other swatch shades that I've seen people do on their arms. So hopefully I don't add to the confusion, I actually give you guys some clarity. Something to note about the packaging is that one of my shades, which is light beige, has a older version of the packaging possibly, because the words are just a little different at the top and the sticker placement on the tube is a little different. Like, it's just like tweaked. This might be the newer, maybe the older. I think it's the older version because the other two seem a little newer, but same formulation, same concealer, same shades. I think they just tweaked it in like where they wanted their words on the box. So this concealer is a full coverage under eye concealer with a very hydrating finish. It has a squeeze tube packaging, retails for $16 each. And as we speak right now, it is 15% off at Target through Target Circle, the whole line. Winky Luxe in general. Word on the street is that you should let it warm up with your fingers. So I'm gonna put a little bit of a drop of each shade so we can get a little swatch going. I have light, light beige, and light medium. I do hear that their fair shades aren't fair enough for most people because they dry darker. Key ingredients would be hyaluronic acid and collagen, which a lot of people feel make their under eyes look really healthy, youthful, plump, and hydrated. These are the three shades. From left to right, we have light, which to me is the most peachy. Light beige gives a weird taupey undertone for something that has the word beige in it, which is interesting. And then the next shade would be light medium. This is actually in order of their shades. I believe there is one lighter shade than this, and then there are 4 more shades after that, which have more of like a medium deep tan situation. I feel like light's gonna give us a really nice correction because it has a little peach underneath it. Light medium's very peachy, but that could still work for me. Light beige is just, what is this? What tone is that? It's very cool tone. And I respect the concept that some people need cool tones, but not as the name light beige. I can see why people get very confused, but if you need that, you'll find it under that shade. Let's try a little bit, oh, it's so creamy, a little bit of light medium first. And I'm gonna pat this in with my fingers a little bit and just see, because some people say that it applies best with your fingers. We're gonna try that on one side. This is not my brightening shade. This is the closest to my skin tone shade, probably. It feels really good. It feels like moisturizer. It's not super tacky. I'm gonna take the rest of my swatch for that shade. Just pat it where I need it most, which is kind of at that bottom of the eye bag. This side actually has worse eye bags, just to be fully transparent. More hollows, I would say. I don't really have bags. I have potholes. But they're natural. They're genetic. But doesn't mean we can't find a nice little hydrating moment. I love a hydrating concealer. Not really much of a fingertip application person, but I want to see how it blends. That's really pretty and natural. It's giving me coverage. while also giving me blend. It does look more obvious on camera than in person because I feel like it's giving a lot of reflection there compared to the rest of my face. But if I put like a face oil on prior, maybe that would help. I'm trying to get really close to the lash line because I feel like there was a spot that wasn't blended. Not bad. I think we are going to take a little bit of light, which is still very creamy on my hand. I don't think this is going to dry in any sort of fashion. And I'm going to put that right on the inner corner to brighten up the area. And then I'm going to take it to the outer edge. The tricky part for this is going to be blending it and patting it in place with your fingers while trying not to move it around because it's so slippery. Just another look at the shade to see if they oxidize at all. I don't really think they did. Light medium is very close to my skin tone, which I would consider as like a light medium to medium right now during this time of the year. I'm definitely getting closer to just the medium. So I've cleaned it off the back of my hand and I have my tray ready so we can get a look at the consistency. You don't really need much at all. That's actually quite a bit. It reminds me of a Joa Beauty concealer, which was a green packaging tube available at CVS, made by Kiss, but promoted as a K-beauty brand. That's kind of the vibes I'm getting. This really doesn't have a lot of information, except for the fact that it just says it's a full coverage under eye concealer with hyaluronic acid and collagen. I wanna try it with this brush. This is the Rare Beauty brush. It's like kind of like a fingertip shape. Though it looks like a cream, it's not heavy at all. Keep in mind, people say you should use your fingers to help warm it up. So we're gonna test that side by side. This is just the shade light. As you can see, it's sitting more on top. Maybe with a sponge, we can press it in. I do kind of like the appearance of the two shades mixed. This is definitely brighter. I wanted to be able to show you guys what it looked like without being mixed. So I've wanted something a little bit more noticeable, a little bit more bright in that area. Maybe I got like more going on. I would probably use this shade by itself, but if I wanted to wear just under eye concealer and not look like there's any sort of discoloration or separation in that area, then I would mix the shades. I kind of like what it looks like. And I wasn't trying to wear too much on my face today, so let's break out Miss Light Medium again and maybe just spot conceal. Taking light medium on my sponge and kind of just going around the outskirts of what we just did and blending it, mixing it together, testing all the application methods and all the combinations right now. I like it together a lot. This is light medium for the redness on my mouth area. A little bit over the acne scars. I feel like the sponge does help diffuse it. Obviously thins it out just a little bit, but not to the point that I would say there's no coverage. There's absolutely coverage. This is just light medium for the acne scars. I would not have assumed that this would be the shade I favored, so I'm glad that I picked up multiple shades. Wow. But man, does a little bit go a long way when it's just your fingers. If you have like a silicone situation, I'm sure that would also spread it around. It just isn't gonna give that heat that your body naturally gives it. It does feel like a serum. It's doing an amazing job at getting my redness. A little coat around my textured areas now. I do have a little redness on my nose going in with light. I feel like my nose is giving me a little trouble because I can't blend it as well with my fingers. I'm just like wiping it around. So sponge to the rescue, pat with precision. It does get the impression of the sponge a little bit. Like you can kind of see little lines. So very, very light tapping. This is what I have left of light medium. That's gonna go kind of across the forehead center. It's gonna be our base of the day. I'm of course gonna, you know, do a little bronze, a little cheek, or maybe just a little glow. We'll see. We'll see where this video takes us. That's gonna be a nice test for the fine lines up there too. It looks good though. Shade wise, my neck is very pale, but it's not too off of my neck shade right now. It seems like just natural. So if you have any left over, obviously for cohesiveness, you can blend it down the neck. I don't have any more on my platter, so I'm just gonna roll with it. Whatever's left on my brush, this is actually the lighter shade. I'm just gonna go across and use whatever residue there is. It's gonna have to do. I think this would be really interesting over a formula that isn't as hydrating. I'd worry a little bit over matte formulations just because I think it's gonna break it up in a weird way because it's so, so hydrating, but it feels really good on. Seems like I have a little left on my brush. It's only on the tip. That really brightened that area up. It looks really smooth. I love the size. I love that it's like lightweight and so pigmented and so affordable. First impressions going really, really well. Let's put on our blush and highlight for the day. I picked up some Refi products from the Sephora sale recently. I have their highlighter, which is the gloss highlighter. Comes in one shade, I believe, but just topaz. And then I got one of their cream blushes, which I think would look really, really pretty on top of what we have going on. All right, we're back. I actually ended up splitting off into a separate video because I am trying three new Refi beauty products, the blush, the highlighter, and the lip. So all the applications will be in my next video because I felt like it's gonna be extra long in this one. But here we are. I wanna give you guys a little glance. We're going blush and highlight only, no contour. So blush is the statement, blush is the moment. But I want you to see how well concealer did play with everything and what is covered and what's still showing. For the most part, we only have a few little freckles showing, and that's, I think, where we were anyway, just in the upper cheek area. But this area looks really smooth. Acne scar that's right here, really nice and covered. Same thing over here, really smooth. This is what the textured areas look like around my face. Not too bad, looks pretty hydrated. Forehead looks like this. I didn't put anything else on there since we didn't do any bronzer. I do feel like the fine lines aren't too bad. I have a feeling it's gonna get a little worse. I'm gonna pat it with a sponge just on one section to see if that helps at all, to see if it helps kind of blend things together and have it not settle into the lines. I wanna test if a little bit of thin, slightly tinted powder will help. So I'm gonna take a little bit of my Kosas powder, which I've been using a lot lately, but it's a very, very fine, like sheer yellow, sheer golden powder. I'm gonna pick this side of my forehead and just tap it really lightly. So it's around the brow there too, all the way up to the hairline. Will that make any sort of difference? I don't know, because the fine lines are kind of the same across. But I think we can do the same thing here, even though this acne scar is showing. That one kind of bothers me. I think I want to conceal it. It's actually just like a pore that got a blackhead that never like settled. You know what I mean? Like it just wanted to scar up instead. I'm using the smallest dot, and I mean smallest dot, this one right here. That's part of the glowy cheek we have going on. Definitely check out the video because look how it looks on the palette versus on my face. Just look. This is the tip of my nose, so a very oily area. As you can see, when I blend it with my fingers, it sheared it out immediately. So maybe we can give it a moment to just, oh. The nose is just not it. Maybe I got too much going on. Maybe there's too many pores. I don't know. But give it a moment. Let it do that and then pack a little powder on that side of the nose and see if that helps us throughout the day. Because I am oily and I feel like this is already very shiny for my nose. We might have to set the whole nose and call it there. See if I can blend the outer edges a little. Not really by much. Taking the other end of this brush and just lightly. It didn't even help, like that acne scar is still showing. So I would say full coverage. I honestly feel like it's more medium at best, but it is advertised as full. Maybe with a powder, depending on what powder you use, different. But there, that actually makes the biggest difference for me. I feel like this still looks hydrated, that center line, but the sides of the nose got what it needed because it's not gonna last otherwise. Should we set one under eye? I'm like talking to the camera like you guys can talk back, just to see if the fine lines don't settle as hard. This one has a stronger fine line, so maybe just a little right here. Now take a good look at that fine line versus this one so we can look at that later. Going across the lid with whatever's left on my brush because my lids get oily, baby, and my highlighter, it goes all the way up here. So let's try to keep what we got going on the lid, a nice little coverage. That is it, that is it. Whatever else will be. All right, final glances before I give you guys close-up cam footage. I did upgrade my phone, so I have the 13 Pro now. But supposedly this huge camera, it's huge, is great. So we're gonna do that for our concealer. On concealer test, I do like to use this so you can really get into that fine lines compared to like a full face close-up cam, which I do for the foundation wear test here. We're really gonna get into it, yeah, you know. So let me leave you guys off with those and I'll see you guys at the end of the day. Is a little after 8 o'clock and we've been wearing our face for 9 hours. I did come into the office around the 5 hour mark, grabbed my powder brush, which had whatever residue from earlier on it, didn't dip into any more, and just kind of tapped it onto my cheekbones because I was looking a little overly dewy compared to the rest of my body. It was before I changed into this long sleeve, but if I was in a summer dress with like cohesive highlight on my collarbone and shoulders, I think it would have been a vibe, but my face looked really, really, really dewy compared to the rest of my body. And I was like, It's making me look greasy compared to not. So that's the only thing I did. That's the only thing that's been changed since we last spoke. Let's get into the close-up cam footage together now. Overall, I think our face looks really healthy and our under eyes still look pretty good. With the chance of even having some of my upper liner transferring down, it's pretty good and I'm happy with it. I did wipe my nose a lot today. The under part of my nose probably doesn't have any product left on it, but the rest of it still looks good. I still have some blush. I still have some highlight. It's definitely worn down with dignity, but I still look even and glowy and hydrated, and it doesn't look bad in any of my textured areas. It's not highlighting any of my pores. Let's look at our forehead together. Powdered side versus not powdered side. I think it honestly kind of just looks the same. So take that how you will. I like the decision we made about powdering the nose because I think that kind of saved us from feeling greasy. It doesn't really feel too greasy. The sides right here are getting a little something, but not much. Very, very little right now, which I like to see. My face feels great. I'm very happy with what we went through today. My neck doesn't feel sticky from the residue that we put on it. It's really good. It's really good. I think when you find the perfect combo of what powder you want to set with it, it would make the concealer last a lot longer in whatever areas, but especially the under eyes. I didn't set it heavily with like a loose powder or anything like that because I really wanted to let it shine through. Let's look for the fine lines. I don't think they look different at all, actually. Do you guys? Not so much. So that's really nice. I think that would be great for those who feel like some concealers settle too much in their lines and or get worse throughout the day. I've definitely tested a few that have done that. This seems to be very forgiving. I did look up wherever this is available. We have Amazon, Ulta, Tarjay, and of course their website. So I will link all of the above down below, and if you need one of the links to shop, you can pick whichever one you want out of those selections and what has your shade in stock. Of course, it's $16 across the board, so that's nice. Overall, I would say this gets my stamp of approval and a grade of an A-. It's pretty good. I think the shades could have a little improvement because I don't know what I'm gonna do with this shade, Miss Light Beige. And maybe, you know, a little extension wouldn't hurt either. But the packaging, amazing. The formula, really great, really comfortable. Absolutely what everyone is saying it is. The hyaluronic acid is hitting. The collagen is definitely mixing up some good medicine. Like, it looks good. It's glowy. If you want something hydrating, glowy, of course. I don't think it's full coverage, but maybe paired with the correct Maybach powder foundation to set it, get it to a coverage level you want if that's what you're looking for. But I would actually say this is closer to medium just because of the formulation. So overall, I hope you guys enjoyed seeing this. I personally love a good short form content, but I'm so detailed that it's hard for me to do something like that because I want to see and hear it all, you know? So if you're also down for it and you're just a YouTube gal at heart, like you really want to see it all, thank you so much for joining me here today. I'm probably gonna do something short and then reference this video on my TikTok just because I haven't actually done anything like that on my TikToks because I have this strong need to be detailed. I see people who are like, ooh, let me try. And this is like no shade to anyone. Let me try this tinted moisturizer. Ooh, so glowy. States like one or two of the claims. It's like, check it out. Buy now. Yeah. And I'm like, what's your skin type? How'd it wear? What did you pair it with? I want to know. It's probably just the Virgo in me who's overly detailed for no apparent reason. But if you also appreciate it, then give a clapping emoji if you made it to this point of the video. Thank you guys so, so much for watching. I appreciate you for spending some of your time of your day with me. It's a very, very cool thing and I never take it for granted. Just remember that. I appreciate your time and you being here. If you'd like to watch any of my other videos, the recent uploads will be on the screen as well as the subscribe button. She's free 99. I'll have another video coming out with a bunch of Refi products soon, so keep an eye out for that. I hope you guys are having a lovely April, staying hydrated, staying healthy, working on everything you need to be working on, right? That is it for me today. I will see you guys in a later video.